Put your hands together, celebrate the Lord Jesus. Celebrate the Master Jesus.
He prayed for me and delivered me, and he mentioned and said that I will receive a text message and a love message. I just looked at myself. I said, me? And so they let God be blamed in watching that, because I know that this is the man that went to my village and sent message that they should come and carry me whatever that belongs to me, or not belongs to him again. Even though I'm living and dying, that it does not concern me. Can you see me? I was surprised. On Wednesday, I was at my shop and I saw his missed call. He was calling. I said, is he calling again? I don't pick the call for the first time. I said, let me be sure of what I'm doing. He repeated the call again. The call that rang and stopped. Three times I picked the call. He said, he now called me and said, how am I? I said, I'm fine. He said, how are you people feeling? He just speaking in the love tongue. I said, enjoy the love.
Celebrate the Lord Jesus. Celebrate the Lord Jesus. Celebrate the Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Put your hands together. Celebrate the Lord Jesus.
After all, when I say, how you put me there? I said, you don't know me. I just managing. I said, he said, give me your account number. I will send money for you.
Wow. Jump your hands together. Celebrate the grace in the house. Put your hands together. Celebrate the Lord Jesus.
Instantly, he sent the call. We start wasting time. Then he called again. I said, have you received the money? He said, yes, manage this one. You are coming. When I come back, I know what to do. I say, no problems. I thank you, sir. God bless you. I just look like I turn around and I say, God, I was shouting. People was asking me what happened. I said, you people do not understand. Come and see what I see. He said, for him to send money and call your phone and text message again. I said, this is the work of God, because I received the message on Sunday.
The husband, they had a serious quarrel. The husband took her to the police station and said, knock her up. And then, serious challenge. At the end, the man left her in the station in the custody and said, marriage come to an end. Was not giving them money, not the next thing. He just traveled to his village. From the village, went to her own father's house and tell them, I'm no longer interested in your daughter. Come and carry her. The next thing she heard, the man went for another engagement for another woman. He's with another woman right now. You want to come to Abuja? Nothing, he said, it was 3,000 naira. For days, the good news, it was 3,000 the brother sent. She brought the money. She used 1,000 naira and ate with the children. And brought 2,000. And come and said, when she came, the children were crying that her father has abandoned us. She was crying, the two daughters were crying, and they don't want to go to the village. The man said they should pack their things and go to the village. It's over. It's over. They cried in the office. They were just crying that, Daddy, please, we don't want to go to the village. We don't want to go to the village. We'll call, he will answer. And then they called. So we said, we should come and carry you. Your husband and cancer, he's not even interested. And then on Sunday, I said, I'm in the father's house right now. Remember? Right? I said, I am in the village. I said, call his name. What is his name? He said, Osita, right? I called the name how many times? 7 times. I said, Osita, come back to your family. And I turned and said, your husband is going to what? Send you a message of love. Now, okay, before the people, when somebody went and handed over somebody to police station, I'm not again interested. Went to the people, my his own people, and the ladies' people, I'm not again interested. And they have gotten another lady for himself. You can't hear that. But you see, the realm of the spirit controls the physical. So I went in the realm and I said, I am right there where Osita is now. Or you go back to your wife. Now this time she was not the one that called again. She said when the man called the first time, she couldn't believe it, so she didn't pick. The man called again. He didn't get angry. He called again, she didn't pick. It was a talker. He said, and the man was talking with a rough voice. He said, why are you looking at me? Are you in love? Said the man was talking to her, not this time, not as a lion again. Talking with a rough voice. Honey, how are you? You know? Praise God. And rather send them money and call to confirm and say, I am coming back soon to come and meet my family as it has been prophesied.